vėl sekundė matant speaker is Vytautas Zinkevicius, business development director of FEMA, and we invited him to make a presentation.
Dear gentlemen, thank you very much for inviting me at this nice event in Palanga. So it's a bit pity that it's only 15 degrees above zero, no 25, which is much better and warmer. So with Algimantas, Mr. Algimantas Valinevičius, I know him for quite long period because I am absolvent of Kaunas University of Technology. At that time it was a radio electronics faculty. So for me it's a double great honor to be here and to tell a bit what's happening in the real market. Actually, I'm representing a company who install things, solutions, systems designed, developed by you. So actually the distance is still very big from the scientific point till the installation point, but I see many good things and also I see many issues, opportunities and so on and so on. So my presentation is based on our company presentation, on company FEMA presentation, which is system integrator, the biggest system integrator in Baltics. So it's not marketing one, but I will try to show the things, how it looks like from system integrator, from project implementation company point. So Nikita? Okay, so what is today's engineering? So it took phrase of Leonardo da Vinci, simplicity is the ultimate sophistication, but a devil is in the details. So actually the point of this sentence that the world is going more sophisticated, but from point of view of technology. But on other hand, all our customers, we expect things to be more simpler, and actually we are somewhere in the middle. We try to make very complex and sophisticated technology more useful for end customer and implement in a way useful for end customer. So it's not easy task, but actually this is I think the main target of companies like we do. So also a few words about engineering. This is what we saw, how we saw the situation yesterday, and the situation is very different today. So many things can be done from a home. So you don't need to go to a site. You don't need to make maybe some hardware. Okay, there is still plenty of hardware works you should do, but many things can be done remotely. Also, so there are still, it's necessary and it's a very important part of all the systems is research and development. While we are involved more in system integration and we are trying to make all those good things working together. So this is, I think, the very, very important goal of our business. So, as I told, FEMA is the leading electronic engineering solution integrator in Baltic countries. And it's also a very interesting point that FEMA as a company was developed by two absolvents of Vilnius University, one of faculty of physics and a faculty of mathematics. And actually, name FEMA is the beginning of Lithuanian words physica and mathematica. And at that time, young students, we started to install security systems because at that time CCTV intrusion access control in was in a great in a great demand from a customer, from a new banks appearing in the market, from private customers and so on. So we had a huge success at that time by providing different engineering system. By growing a company, so we started to make our offer bigger and bigger. So today, actually, our package, we can offer almost all engineering system except maybe factory automation. And the most interesting thing that all the systems you provide, you install for customers should work together, should be integrated, should be must provide efficiency for end customer, and this is a very important thing. So our aims was and is to develop and implement electronic engineering solutions to modernize public and private infrastructure. So actually we are participating in many private and public projects where while modernizing its infrastructure from railways to airports. Also one of the growing industry is intelligent transportation systems. It's also very important in our region in order to develop economy and so on. So on. You should have a well modernized infrastructure of transportation and so on. While our customers' needs, it's of course get the best and the cheapest solution. It's all the time. So we say that when you come to end customer, you should have gentleman kind of gentleman pack. It's a gentleman pack. It means you should have of course good relationship with end customer. You should have good solution. And of course, your price should be the best. So this reality is that in every single details, the customers will look for efficiency, for the best pricing, and so on, so on. So from engineering point of view, sometimes and even in most cases, we are as engineers, we try to build a monument in each project. We try to build a monument by saying, wow, we need to make like engineering some interesting things, integrated, highly sophisticated, and so on, so on. And in most cases, customer we doesn't understand why we need to pay for this good thing, interesting, highly integrated, and so on, so on. So this is really big issues for us. Also, simply, we expect answers, but not another questions. We expect tailored suits, but not standard from a shelf. We expect have a reliable partner through all the cycles of project. So it looks like, okay, it could be very easy to for example, okay, I would like to build engineering infrastructure. So someone, I will write contract with somebody who will make design, somebody who will make installation, and somebody who will make after sales, service and maintenance. Indeed, the situation is that all three parts, we talk in different language, and in most cases, designers, we do all outdated designs, we use all the outdated technologies, implementation companies, we have their own goals, we provide their own solutions, while service and maintenance, we look from perspective of usability of a system and so on, so on. This is highly complex market and it's very growing market, but still we have many different talks languages among the interesting parties. And the very big issue is to find common language. And also, do not waste from customer view is don't waste time on bargaining with dozens of different engineering solution suppliers. Have only one. Also, more we get into the engineering world in the around into infrastructure, the more solutions we face. The last our installation in Minsk Aqua Park, we installed more than 25 different engineering systems. Actually, the amount of project was around 7 million euros, and it was highly complex. For end customer, it was actually we couldn't manage to even to buy such amount of systems, different systems working together and so on. Even during the specification phase, it was big problems to make what I expect, what I would like to have at the end of the day and so on, so on. So therefore, engineering role, it's not only to develop very, very good and sophisticated machine, but also to make it usable to for day by day activities and so on. So it's a bit about the region where we are active. So actually today we are in Poland, Belarus, Lithuania, Latvia, tomorrow will be Norway, Sweden, Denmark. So this a bit about the services. It's as I said, from consulting, design, installation, contracting, service maintenance. So actually all that services, it's a typical services of system integrator. And it's really pity that the more we are involved in the big infrastructure, interesting engineering projects, the far we are from real electronics engineering and so on, so on. We are starting to be rather general contractor, rather project manager, but not the one like we started 20 years ago, where company was full of enthusiasm, providing different electronic engineering stuff with many interesting features. But the reality is that most of our end users, we do not have enough time to spend to check all these features and to know the situation in the market and so on, so on. We try to rely on a service provider. And so that's why we also should transform. We try to transform technical language to a business language, and it's not easy task. So this is a so typical solution package or portfolio of our company. Some figures, but just a few things that more than 10,000 projects implemented in the region. More than 500 service sites serviced by our service center, and of course many of ongoing and implemented projects. So our team, few words, also our 500 employee professionals in all three countries. And also, this is also quite important thing, it's a structure of a company. I would like to show that one of the quarter companies engineers, and I think it's in spite of the situation changing market, I think it's the most important and it's key cornerstone of our company, and to have engineers in-house, not to order them to find in the market, but rather to have in-house to provide up-to-date the newest, the best solution for end customer. And even during the crisis, we need to look around how to reduce personnel and so on, and even cut salaries and so on, so on. And actually, this part remained the same during this economic crisis time. So many technology partners, social activity partnership with universities. It's a partnership with Kaunas University of Technology, Riga Technical University, National Students Academy. So in order to promote engineering, electronic engineering, we also invest, we participate in various students events to promote, to back from business management to again to engineering, but because in my opinion it's very interesting, and looking to the future, it's very important profession. So some information also about the projects in the market, what type of projects we have, and where those good engineering solutions could be used, and there are many of different It's one of them, for example, it's one of our ongoing projects we involved is electrification of a railway section between Vilnius and the Belarus border. So actually it's a first project since last project was done more than 30, even 40 years ago between Kaunas and Vilnius. And this is the first project. And in this type of project, we have different engineering systems. Our sales team, in order to acquire this project, our sales team was comprised of around 20 employees who are professionals in different segments of activities. And so, therefore, I would like to say that it's a very important to be and to know such different systems and make it working together. So, therefore, that allows us to be in the and in the winning position in such projects. Also, it's we are very proud of this project. It's a modernization of Kaunas Kybartai. It's one of a railway section. It was a very interesting, also a huge project. It took us 2 years for preparation phase and another 2.5 years for implementation phase. Actually, we're very proud because of this is the only one project of such a size in Lithuanian railways which was implemented in terms and with no delays. So we're it's really strange, but the situation is that the poor preparational phase caused many problems during the installation, and also we should develop not only our engineering skills, but we should try somehow to persuade and develop customers' engineering skills and their perception of the system's efficiency, of advantages, and so on, so on. For example, our neighbor, we have our subsidiary in Poland, and our affiliate daughter company FIMA Polska. For example, we're quite active in Polish railways modernization. And for example, last year, it was the budget of about 9 billion zloty in Polish railways, and only 4.5 billion zloty was consumed because of simply of lack of engineering, design resources, and so many things. So many projects are approaching to the market, but there are no companies can consume, can get those projects, which can implement in time and in budget. So it's a huge issue for our like a system integrator market business and so on, so on. In the same, for example, Lithuania, there is a plan to make modernization and installation of electrification of around 600 million euros in coming EU funding period. So it's a huge money. So I think we as a country, we can prepare students, we can invest in from studying right technical. For example, we're stressing very much on preparation of railway signaling engineers, which are now in demand in all Europe, because modernization of railways is happening not in only in Lithuania, in Poland, but in all Europe. Some projects in Latvia also, each project has its own specific. For example, in this project we have also, it's another kind of gentleman pack. We are providing all the electronic engineering systems, also power supply, telecommunication, and railway signaling. And it's really interesting project. It's because of its complexity, also safety requirements, and so on, so on. It was built according to the latest CIL-4 safety requirements. It's necessary for European railways. So it's a good example. So another many system installed by us in Vilnius International Airport, Kaunas, Palanga, and so it's much easier to list what kind of system are missing in those airports. You can see many new modern opportunities. So actually, it's a really. There are a lot of many interesting projects in our region, market, and so on, so on. And I think the companies having good engineering potential have enough to do in this region. And I think we have really good experience accumulated during the installation. So, therefore, we even as a company, we think that for some even for some markets, for some solution, we have a kind of exceeded experience, which can be even later exported to other countries, to Europe and to maybe even far east, in I don't know, in America and so on, so on. Thanks for such customers like the Teo. Teo is one of our best customers, and for example, we decided to buy, for example, cooling system, which was at least 10 times, at least 5 times more expensive, but the usage of energy was more than, I would say, 50 times less than the normal, typical, outdated cooling solution for server rooms. So there are not so many customers we buy much more expensive solution looking at the period where you would like to use the solution and with what will be savings and so on, so on. Some traffic information system is also, it's another ongoing trend in the market that there are many projects in the development phase in intelligent transportation system. So our company installed many speed cameras in all over Lithuania, meteor detectors and so on, so on. So actually we see more and more electronics on our roads, because typically it was okay, we have some signs. And maybe electronics, some lightning, depending on solar panels, on wind generators, and that's it. But today we have intensity meters, we have special meteor detectors which can detect the thick of ice and to send, for example, truck with salt not to this area. Where was no problem, but in spite of us hard snowing, but sent the same track to another area where the thick of ice is really huge, and so it's better to go there and to put salt on the road. So everything going more efficient. Okay, so we are this market, engineering market, integration market is really conservative one. It's not so easy to persuade to use new solutions, but I think it's going right direction, right path, and where more customers understand how it's important to look at the not only at the primary installation cost, but also at the savings efficiency, the more we get a job for our some interesting also installation. It's one of the pilot projects of public priority transport system in Kaunas. So for this installation security system, we've got award of Minister of Economy of Republic of Lithuania. So after Russian cut the Druzhba pipeline, oil pipeline, so this was the only one point for Lithuania to import crude oil for Mažeikiai oil refinery, and it was no security on this buoy. So actually, everybody can come with boat and to make some And finally, Orlen decided to install security systems. It was a huge, I wouldn't say problem, but for us it was interesting project because this boy is around 10 kilometers in the sea, and without any electricity, without telecommunications, we were needed to provide power supply, we needed to provide telecommunication channel with coast. And another issue that if you make it a radio transmission, so you should keep in mind that typically the ship is connected to a buoy in opposite direction to the wind is blowing, and when wind is blowing from the sea, so the ship is standing between the buoy and the shore and the coast, so you need to make spare radio transmission connections. So we did three spare connections. I also installed special solar panels for silt environment. We installed special wind generators. So it was really interesting. It wasn't big of million of euros, but it was interesting. And I think we are very proud by such installation that where we can, having such engineers, we can find right tailored solution, not the suit like this, but made for you. It's also main installation of our company done by for perimeter protection for state border guard service. And also unique point of this project is that it's not to install perimeter protection system on the border. It's not big deal. The big deal, the detail is that we have situation that in Lithuania, especially in winter time, we have a climate situation when is plus 1, plus 2, 0, minus 2, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, plus 2, again minus 2. So we have frozen, and if we in 90% of detectors, we cannot work in such environment. So we need to make double checks. We need to make install different kind of technology to combine them. If somebody try to go to get over the border, so we detect with video detection. Later on, we detect with some buried cable technologies and so on. We develop something new, but we rather try to find the things in the market and integrate it in the way it is more the most efficient. Some also staff vehicle access control time and attendance system is also interesting thing that it's not big deal. Again, access control system. Everybody knows tags, cards, get to the door with a card and you can open door, and so everything is okay. But the software was developed based on our experience, on 2 decades experience, and we put quite many interesting things. Some tailored things which is necessary for a customer, and we developed it and customer is very happy. So we spent I think 3 or 4 years looking for similar software in the market, and the result was nothing, and we managed to do this installation within 1 year. And actually now this fertilizer project factory project plant project was taken as a pilot project in all the Eurohem group, which is a worldwide group. Some very specific fire suppression systems also brought to Lithuania, installed by us. Construction of public health laboratories of bio safety levels. So this is also a famous project of ours. It's also a good example what was in previous time. In previous time, the situation was that typically the construction company will takes the project and say, okay, so the most important thing is windows, doors, floors, bricks, and so on, so on. This is the power of a building, and the cables also. It's rubbish. It's nothing. So let's spend less for cablings for and so on, so on. Now the taking into account the complexity of technology of required systems and so on, so on. In, for example, in this particular big building is Vilnius University Science Valley, the engineering part is equal to a construction part. So we have more than 30 different systems, and in such projects, we as an engineering company can take a lead and say, okay, guys, from a construction company, your bricks is very and windows and doors are very important, but it's not the most important in such projects like Science Valley. So also, I mentioned in the beginning, it's an engineering system for Minsk Aqua Park is also. And the interesting thing is also that we managed to install 20 different engineering systems within 5 months. So we've got winning information last day of 2013, and we signed contract next week in the beginning of 2014. And actually, the owners of this aqua park, it was Minsk municipality, where they told us, okay, you know that in the beginning of May, Mr. Alexander Lukashenko will come to swim in this aqua park, so we have no chance to to delay. So therefore, it was huge interesting project, but also it's another was many discussions about the design, project design, about the okay, what is designed and what we should do in order to make it working normally, normal way, useful way. So it's another also interesting project for is Teo data center. So the first unit was, it's also an interesting thing that so we presented in the market Kyoto Cooling. It's a Dutch technology. The basic of this technology is the usage of outdoor air to cool down server room. And in most cases, if we talk about Lithuania, we have only 2 weeks where outdoor temperature exceeds data center temperature. So therefore, in all of the time, we can use outdoor air to cool down servers. And at that time, it was a superior technology, but nobody knew about such a technology because it was totally green. And it was quite expensive and so on, so on. But finally, after a long discussion with Teo, with many calculations, even it was written in contract, if the consumption of energy will exceed a certain amount, written in technical specifications, we will pay for Teo all the extra usage of power of electricity. And I am happy to say that we never paid. So I think it's a good, not only for us, but also for Teo, that we decided to invest in advanced technologies. Okay, in some cases, we may fail due to many reasons. Because new technologies is new technologies. There is certain risk. Some also installation of data center for Latvian State Radio and Television Center. And I decided to write some key issues and opportunities for us as market players, for all the market and so on. I think one of the issues is still the main procurement winner selection criteria is based on the lowest price. It's a really big problem. Now there is some steps forward to avoid that in order to make transition from the lowest price to the best value. It's according to EU new regulations. So it means that especially public companies will be forced to buy not according to the lowest price, but look about the service and maintenance, look about the cost of exploitation and efficiency and so on and so on. It's I think it's a core requirement for us that it should be like this, because if we talk about the lowest price, it's never ending story. You can sell the system for €1 if it's necessary, but what will be result? So okay, so some results we saw in our presentation, so you can see women sitting in office and printing, so because the camera was outdated and nobody cares about that. So also, as another issue is lack of skilled market players. It's not only the problem of a customer. I think it's a problem of all chain. It's a design integrator, project engineer, customers, and also the same. That it's very important that universities will also should follow path of technical requirements necessary for a market, necessary for end customers. Okay, they're changing, but not in the way like Moore law every 2 years 10 times or something like that. So it's we need to be ready for more sophisticated solutions, and for us also, we are as a company, we are staying in the middle. It's one thing, as I said in the beginning, it's a technology becomes too complex. On the other hand, the customers we do not go in details into technology. We try to, okay, so I would like to have it on a mobile phone and just to control from my laptop, PC, and so on. So I don't want to care about anything what is behind, and it's really a big for us, it's big issue to manage, to leverage process. And also that many decisions are short-sighted. It's based on investments, but not on the cost during the certain period. Also, engineering market, believe me, is a very resistant and conservative market. So if you look at a certain part of security solutions where we were designed 20, 30 years ago. Maybe it's good now looking from threats, from security threats, because technologies are outdated. It's not too easy to get into the systems because we are simply too simple. But on the other hand, it's a big issue actually that the market is not very much dynamic actually, even vice versa. So, but besides of issues, we have opportunities. It's as I said, expand our accumulated access competence to markets around the Baltic Sea. So thanks to EU funding, thanks to many modernization projects, we accumulated quite interesting experience, and we have certified specialist, very well known in all the region regarding the data center infrastructure. And actually, but if we evaluate our local market, we have 3, 4, 5 projects per 2-3 years maximum. There is no big need for much bigger development in the region. So wherefore, we are looking to, how to say, to offer, to rent our specialist to other markets, to maybe provide services and go somewhere else. So it's also an interesting opportunity. And of course, we're waiting for another EU funding, which is coming, unfortunately, with big delays and with many problems, but I hope in 2017 we'll get first projects, first money from new period projects, and let's see. And of course, there's increased demand for efficiency in areas of data centers, transport infrastructure, utilities, etc. It's never-ending process actually. And once you stop modernizing one part of a certain customer, so after the ending, you look around the new project within the same customer, because simply the system are changing, everything demands are changing, and so on, so on, so. So good, the good news that definitely we'll have to do what to do within next 100 years at least. So thanks from my side, and any questions?
I am curious about Kyoto cooling system. How can we use OSAT air cooling the data center? Because for example, in the summer, the OSAT temperature may be 30 degrees.
Yeah, so for this particular period, you have standard air conditioning units installed in the Kyoto cooling. And if temperature goes over 21, I think 21, it's above a certain level, threshold, immediately this internal cooling starts up and cool down additionally. So it's particularly used for this 2 weeks period in all other, during all other the year, you don't need any extra cooling. So it's enough to have outside air.
Which company has a solution for the Kyoto cooling?
It's Kyoto cooling, it's a company name. Many companies like APC, like Emerson, we started to make a kind of copies, we started to introduce similar solutions. But in general, I think it's Kyoto cooling, it's a market leader in this particular segment. And really, we save a lot on power consumption, because you can imagine one thing is to cool down the liquid, to use obsolete air conditioning system and so on, which is has big usage of electricity. And I think if you use a typical, this Kyoto cooling is based on a recuperator principle. But it's a bit different, but it's recuperator. And actually, you should pay for the electricity of electronics, it's controller, and electricity of motor, electric motor that turns the wheel for changing the air, for mixing the air, coming out from a data center and coming from outside and mixing together and cooling down. So that's it. Nothing else. So wherefore, average usage of electricity is very low.
More questions?
You are a system integrator and you acquire subsystems many times or quite often. The question I wanted to ask, if you look in an average sense, which is the key criteria when you make a decision to acquire this subsystem from that supplier? Because they, I guess, also are sophisticated systems that are characterized by many parameters, by different set of parameters. So what is the key criteria when you make selections?
You know, there are a set of criteria. First, I think the most important, okay, it's a joke, but it's not the joke only. It's we inherit it from end customers, is of course the price. We look at the price, but it's not the most important thing. I think another, it's we look at the technology. Is it new? Is it how long it will be in the market? Because all the market players we have situation. It's no excuses. Everybody has. Once we are market leaders, next day we have many problems with and trying to develop something new in order somehow to keep on the edge of. So it's one thing. Another thing is for us as a system integrators, it's also quite difficult to manage to to train our people on all available technologies. Wherefore, we do selection. We do selection, for example, if talking about BMS, BIM building management system, there are hundreds of systems. So we selected two, three maximum, and we sent our people, engineers, we train them, we pass all of the necessary courses in order to get not only certificates, but good understanding of system installation and also exploitation. So this is a set of criteria. And wherefore, I showed the slide with our partners list. Actually, we have hundreds of partners, different partners, but only with certain group of partners we try to work in more or less in exclusive base, because we understand that we keep path almost all time. But also, it's for example, the best example is Avaya. So yesterday it was wow, super company, making super telephony systems and so on, so on. Today we are struggling what to do, because there is no telephony like it was a decade ago, when you open a 9-inch rack, you connect. So when you buy telephony, you buy a disc, that's it. Nothing else, and telephones on but it's also, it depends on you. You can install it via IP telephones or other brand. So this is, I think, the main selection criteria. And of course, it's changing. After a certain period, we try to look around what's happening in the market, to listen paths, the station, and try to get new partners, try to so also a good example is we for two I think for 20 years we were partnering with American well-known company thermal cameras provider FLIR, so we were market leader for two decades. Nobody can say against them. But now situation, we simply dream too long. And actually, this we switched to another company, Opgal, which is an Israeli company, and the technology is much better. And for same price, you get much more features. And okay, so you try to bring feedbacks to the same FLIR and say, okay, guys, you should improve this and this and this and this, because we need to compete in the market. We need to see what's happening, what our competitors are doing, and so on, so on. So we follow market. We know what's happening.
Any more questions?
Okay, no more questions. Thank you for your presentation.
Thank you.
Gift. Once you have one, not so much.
I'll give Andrews to test it before. Okay, thank you.
So, it's time for the lunch. Lunch is served in the restaurant of this hotel. So, let's go.